Do you think the new PoE standard BT, aka PoE++, can increase the total power budget in your PoE system? Sometimes the answer may not be what you expected. In this video, we are going to talk about how this new PoE system works. More importantly, we will talk about whether it can deliver what you need or not. Before we jump into the video, make sure you hit the like button below because it really helps with the YouTube algorithm and it will really make my lot easier. Now let's get right into it. The new PoE standard can supply up to 90 watt high power because it's taking all 4 twist pairs in the K5U or K6 Ethernet cable to send the power. There's 4 twist pairs in this cable, and the preview PoE standard plus is only taking half of the twist pair to send the power. So the new PoE standard increased the total power budget from 30 watt to 90 watt. But you may don't know is there are 4 steps before the PoE injector and PoE switch need to go through before it send the power over the K5U or K6 Ethernet cable. The first step is the verification. You need to verify your edge device, such as the camera, access point, is also compatible with the PoE. If you determine your edge device is not PoE compatible product, the PoE injector or switch will not release the power. The second step is the classification. The PoE injector and PoE switch will classify your edge device and determine what is the maximum power budget you need to send over the K5U or K6 Ethernet cable. For example, if you just connect a PoE Plus IP camera to a 90 watt PoE injector or PoE switch, this PoE injector or switch will recognize your edge device only support PoE Plus and will set the maximum power budget to 30 watt. The third step is the power up. After the PoE injector or PoE switch verify and classify your edge device, it will start sending the power over the K5U or K6 Ethernet cable. It will increase the voltage from low voltage to the high voltage. The fourth step is the monitoring. The PoE switch or PoE injector will monitor the whole power system. If there are any abnormal, like the overload or short circuits, the PoE switch or PoE injector will shut down the power immediately. From here, we do know you're not going to increase the total power unless you have the whole PoE system support the new PoE standard BT. Not only the PoE injector or PoE switch, but also the edge device. If you have using any PoE standard solution like the PoE standard also need to support PoE. I just got an email from one of the customers. He have the 100 watt PoE injector and also the IP camera which require 60 watt. But he's using the PoE standard to repeat the PoE network, and the PoE standard only support PoE Plus. So the whole system is running PoE Plus, which is taking 30 watt. It's not going to have enough power to supply the PoE camera. What if we want to have the high power, but one of the devices like the IP camera doesn't support high power PoE? In this case, we can use the PoE splitter. Okay, now let's move to the demonstration board and see how we can use the PoE splitter to work with the high power PoE system. This is the PoE switch with the latest PoE standard BT. The port 1 and port 2 can output 90 watt. Port 3 and port 4 output 30 watt. This switch allows us to change the PoE protocol. This switch also supports PoEH and UPoE. This is a Pentel zoom camera with heater built-in. It will consume about 45 watt, but it doesn't support PoE. So I had to use this PoE splitter. The splitter has 3 ports. These 2 are the RJ45 network port. We're supposed to connect the cable from the PoE switch to this PD port and connect the cable to the camera by using this data port. This DC output, it will supply the power for the Pentel zoom camera. Okay, now let's just hook up the whole system. First, let me connect the NVR to this high power PoE switch. This is the data port, so I will connect the NVR to the data port. Also, this switch using the external power supply. Now, the switch is being powered up. I'm going to connect the cable from the port 1 and port 2 because these 2 ports can supply high power. Okay, next, let's move to the camera end. First, I will hold up the PoE splitter. And now let's connect the cable from the PoE switch to this PD input port. Now you can see the power indicator is on, which means that this PoE splitter is getting the power from the PoE switch. we need to also need to hold up the power coat so we can supply the power for the camera. Now let's connect the DC to the power input of the pan-tilt-zoom camera. You can see the camera is start initiating, it's just pan and tilt zoom, which means the camera is getting the power from the PoE switch. I also need to connect this data cable to the data port of the PoE splitter. The PoE splitter also will perform four steps between the PoE switch. First, the PoE switch will determine the edge device. This is the PoE splitter, it needs the power. And second step, it will classify the maximum power budget this PoE splitter required. PoE splitter can output 60 watts, so it will go for the BT certification. The next step is start sending the power, then it will monitor it. And the reason we can have the such high power is because both PoE switch and PoE splitter also can support the new PoE standard. The one last thing is about the power output. Actually, the PoE splitter has the regulator built-in, it will step down the PoE to DC 12 voltage. So in this system, you not only can work with the pan-tilt-zoom camera, as long as your edge device requires DC 12 voltage and you also need the power, then you can use this high power system. Just one last thing, the new PoE standard actually never improved the distance between the PoE switch and the PoE edge device. The PoE is still limited to about 328 feet. If you want to increase the PoE distance, you can reference my another video how to use the PoE extender to increase the PoE distance beyond 328 feet.